Oh, I need a football jacket.
And now, live in studio, cutting through your typical media nonsense and offering you a rational and unbiased perspective to current events and life in Tampa Bay, he's a successful entrepreneur, a real estate and finance expert, and goes to bat for you every day as your consumer advocate, your host, Brandon Rimes.
Yes, here we are again another day committed to picking a fight with the mainstream media and providing you the timely truth centered around your real estate, credit, finance, estate planning, home remodeling, small business law, and so much more. You're listening to the Real Estate Quarterback Show, Tampa Bay's number one consumer advocate platform, and we're here to help our consumers win in any marketplace.
The only thing I'm addicted to right now is winning.
Now, I want you to pull out your smartphone and save this number in your phone because at some point you're going to need it. It's our consumer advocate hotline. It's 813-917-1894. Baby, don't forget. 813-917-1894, and also bookmark realestateradiotampa.com. A plethora of resources. You can see links to all of our partners that you're going to hear from today. And this is Intelligent Talk Radio. I've got some intelligent folks here in studio to help you win in any marketplace, as we say. And this segment is brought to you by Freedom Boat Club. It's the official recreation partner of the Real Estate Quarterback Show. Great opportunity to go out and enjoy the boating here in beautiful Tampa Bay and this beautiful weather we have. All right, before we jump into this content, I want to touch on a couple of hot listings. I've got a penthouse here at 19451 Gulf Boulevard, number 803, in Indian Shores. This is a two-bedroom, two-bath property, top floor, beautiful views of both the morning sunrise and the sunsets in the evening at Indian Shores, looking at the beautiful Gulf of Mexico. We have it made here in Tampa Bay, a great place to work, live, work, and play. And also have a 27-acre ranch. Any developers, home builders out there, I got a 27-acre ranch just south of the Citrus Park Mall, just east of the Veterans Expressway here in Tampa. 27 acres, beautifully wooded property, set up currently as a horse ranch. And also have 18620 Wayne Road in Odessa. Four bedrooms, actually nine bedrooms, five and a half bath. And it's a $1.6 million waterfront property here in beautiful Tampa Bay. Also, shouts out to all of our Periscopers out there watching us. We got a TV show now. A lot of cool things to talk about. Let's go ahead and jump into this great content. I've got, first up, back in studio, repeat offender, back in studio, Jason Avery, longtime friend of the Real Estate Quarterback Show, Avery Construction. Welcome back in, my friend.
Thanks for having me, man. It's glad to be back.
What are we going to talk about today?
Well, you know, I got a book that just launched, and it's a book called Constructing Success.
Nice.
And everybody expects, coming from a contractor, it must be all about being a contractor, and really it's not. It's a book for all business owners, managers, outside salespeople. It's a book about building relationships with people that generate you referrals.
That's right.
We've gotten really good at Avery Construction about managing a customer's experience, understanding where the highs and the lows are that are going to affect the client's emotions.
That's right.
And so we work very hard to try and stay a step ahead of the client and know where the pitfalls may be so that we can take some proactive steps to make sure that it's not so disheartening and so that you know, they're a little more comfortable throughout the process.
And excellent.
It's that keeping the customers comfortable that keeps the phones ringing.
That's so right.
I try to share a lot of this information in my new book. It's available on Amazon right now. It's also available in a Kindle download. We have officially hit number one twice over now in the category of business management.
Very cool.
So very excited about that, and that does good things for us. It means that Amazon will actually start marketing it now on their own to their own database of people. So
nice.
That should help us gain a lot of additional exposure. But The theory behind the book is it's actually my next business venture in a company called Constructing Success.
Very cool.
As we're now going to start coaching and consulting some of the other contractors in town, some of these smaller guys that just have a handful of employees, and trying to help them take the business to the level that we've achieved. We're now in our four and a half years in business, and in working on our fifth year, we've now climbed to 25 people working full time. Nice. We're going to do over $3 million in gross volume this year, and I've really positioned myself to work more on the business as opposed to in the business. So I'm out there every day meeting those architects and interior designers and people who are relevant to our industry.
Shouts out to Gerald McCants, architecture. Partner of the Real Estate Quarterback Show. Let's go ahead and round the horn here and introduce as well. I've got Scott Silverman, Ackerman LLP, in studio. He's a small business attorney. He's in studio for the first time. Welcome in.
Brandon, thank you so much for having me. Excited to be here.
Hey, my pleasure. And today we're going to talk about some of the common pitfalls that small business owners sometimes have and ways that we can help educate them.
Yes, yes. We have the top three mistakes that small business owners may make with regard to their employees. So we're going to talk about that. Also going to talk about some developments in employment law to help out the small business owners to understand what they need to do with regard to their employees to stay in compliance with the law, and have some tips as well. So looking forward to it.
That's right. Yeah. Hey, the small business backbone of the United States.
And now I know for sure I just added two more guys to my wolf pack.
Two more guys to the wolf pack. We got that. All right. So, and also my lovely co-host, Danielle Berg, in studio.
Thanks, Brandon. We have a spooky lineup today.
All right.
We're going to answer some scary questions from homeowners during our Ask the Real Estate Quarterback. And then we also have a couple feel-good stories during our newest Tell Me Something Good segment.
That's right. Tell Me Something Good. Tell Me Something Good. So tell me, we got a quick tease of a Tell Me Something Good. I want to get this in on the first segment. I had kind of hit home here, close to home. I had a cousin of mine just found out a couple weeks ago he's been battling cancer. And I think it was News Channel 8 did a story on Paul Dombrowski that came out. And, you know, he's a male and he had breast cancer. Yeah. And, you know, so it's one of those things you come in and, you know, you don't expect it. But, you know, the News Channel 8 did a story on it. He's actually a former NFL football player, played for the Chiefs, played for the Buccaneers in the creamsicle years, and also the New England Patriots as well. So came out and took a lot of courage of him to do that. And he's speaking out to raise awareness for breast cancer. And, yes, men can get it. I think the statistic is something like 8,000 men a year die in the United States from that. But, yeah, in the New England Patriots, I heard they ran it during the halftime of their game last week. But, you know, interesting story and, you know, something good. You know, we take it, flip a negative to positive, right? So you're listening to the Real Estate Quarterback Show, all-star lineup. I don't care if you're climbing a corporate ladder or if you throw a ladder in your truck on the way to work. This show's for you. We're Tampa Bay's number one consumer advocate, actually stretching all the way down to Fort Myers, Naples. Huge viewership audience. We have a TV show now as well, Danielle.
Yeah, Sundays at 8 p.m. on This TV Tampa Bay. You can check us out. Bright House Channel 630 and Verizon Channel 463. So it's every Sunday night at 8 p.m.
Yeah, and we also have a big event coming up, Wine, Women, and Shoes here in Tampa Bay. I've actually honored to host this year's Wine, Women, actually MC this year's Wine, Women, and Shoes event for a great cause, Children's Cancer Center. Doing a lot of good things, trying to help out, you know, in the community here, Wine, Women, and Shoes, November 20th, Friday, November 20th. Please check it out. Please engage. Please get your tickets. And the hashtag for social media is WWSTampa. And Wine, Women, and Shoes, shouts out to all the fine folks over there at Children's Cancer Center. Kristen and Patty, they do such a great job over there helping raise, and Steve Manuel, helping raise awareness for the, you know, the families that are struck with that awful illness and helping them overcome. So we want to help you win in any marketplace. That's the goal of our show. So Intelligent Talk Radio. Let's jump back over here to Jason Avery, Avery Construction, Home Remodeling. You know, a lot to talk about in that space, especially with being a top listing agent here in Tampa. I see a lot of, you know, walk into the house, you see that wall that's there from the 80s or 90s that shouldn't be there. You know, what are you seeing out there, Jay?
Absolutely. You know, those waterfront homes, they always tend to have those unnecessary walls in the way that are obstructing that $1 million view you paid for.
That's right.
So, yeah, we come into a lot of those homes and knock those walls down. Sometimes they required some engineering or, you know, load-bearing beam work, you know, columns. But, yeah, we like to widen the spaces and maybe venture out of what was the kitchen into a great room concept.
Yeah.
But, yeah, my consumer advocacy topic for today is really just to educate the homeowners about what to avoid when shopping contractors, things to look out for. I think it's great that we have our employment attorney in the house today who can, you know, help speak to some of these concepts. But there's a lot of contractors out there who aren't employing their people correctly. And this is a big liability for the homeowner. What happens is they are not running them through payroll role as a regular employee, because then they would have to match the employer taxes and they would have to pay for work comp deductions. So they tend to try and set these people up as an independent contractor, the way they would call it. Pretty much just pay gross dollars and then hand the person a 1099 at the end of the year. Well, that person then is not covered under work comp. Yep. And, you know, if an accident happens with the chop saw, or, you know, somebody loses a hand or a foot and they can't work for the rest of their lives, believe me, when they talk to some attorneys, that employee is going to find that there's many people there that can be sued, not just the contractor, but also the homeowner's insurance. And if that's not going to be enough to pay the damage, then even the homeowner's personal assets. So shopping your contractor and doing your due diligence to make sure that, A, they either have employees covered under payroll with taxes and work comp deductions, or that it is a true subcontractor, meaning they have to furnish a general liability certificate, a waiver of work comp certificate, their license, and a W-9. But then yet you still need to make sure that that waiver of work comp covers only officers of a company, only up to three.
Yeah, definitely. We want to help you think a layer deeper here with the Real Estate Quarterback Show. More from Jason Avery, Avery Construction, Scott Silverman, and Danielle Berg, expert buyer agent, when we come back. And we're also going to talk about some interesting stories in the news. We've got buy versus rent in Tampa Bay, home ownership costs less if you can qualify, and also Michael Jordan's bold plan to sell his $15 million home. Slam dunk or foul? You're listening to the Real Estate Quarterback Show, realestateradiotampa.com.
This is Warwick Dunn, and you're listening to the Real Estate Quarterback Show, hosted by my man, Brandon Rimes.
All right, welcome back. Thanks for sticking with us. Brandon Rimes here, host of the Real Estate Quarterback Show, owner of Platinum MVP Realty, or a top listing agent here in Tampa Bay as well. Featured in Florida Realtor Magazine multiple times, recognized for my innovations with marketing. And this segment is brought to you by my health team. Kicking off the lineup with the health team is Adrian Falcone Godsell. She's a personal chef, holistic healing chef, cooks these awesome organic meals, chickens, quinoas, great veggies, and it's just a, you know, teasing the palate every day, just something different. So I love that opportunity. She delivers the food on Mondays. Great opportunity. Also, she also does cooking classes as well. And so what else do you have in this world if you don't have your health? So you got to make sure you're eating right. Feed that machine as an ex-athlete. Very important. Also, Back in Health Massage. Shouts out to Michael Vogt. He's an excellent massage therapist, several modalities of massage, and also for me, a stretching regimen that really helps out with my low back and my hips and you know, the legs and some of that good stuff. So the health team, very important. You have a great health team out there. We got them on realestateradiotampa.com. You can see links to all of our partners there, as well as an expert contributor panel. So we got Intelligent Talk Radio, Intelligent folks in studio and also on the phones. I asked Michael Lysenko, he's our safe money coach. I asked Michael to call in and give us an update on the marketplace. Hey, Michael.
Hey, Brandon, how are you?
Hey, doing wonderful, man.
Good. So what would you like to know this week? The word is on the street is volatility. It's
yeah.
It's been that way for about the last 3 or 4 months, it seems.
Yeah, so you're telling me earlier there's some movements in oil. What's the main factors that you see out there that's going to be affecting people's retirement?
There's three of them right now, and they've just been kind of stalling the market or moving it in all sorts of directions. Number one is oil. Number two is China. And number three is the Federal Reserve. So yeah. I don't think you could get more diverse from that, but it's really having an effect on people's money.
Yeah, it is. You know, it's interesting with the Federal Reserve as well here. You know, they keep pushing this down the road. It's like, you know, we got to start raising rates at some point. You know, we've got inflation that could set in. It's a problem.
Well, it is a huge problem, especially since everybody is kind of you got itchy fingers right now as far as trigger fingers. And, you know, the minute the Fed makes a hint one way or the other, it drives the market in a certain direction. And I agree. I think that it's going to be good for everybody to start raising the rates. But it's going to be interesting initially when they do it, what the short-term and then the long-term effects on the stock market's going to be.
Yeah. It's you know, I relate it to a baseball player, football player on steroids. You know, they inject those steroids, they hit a bunch of home runs, and that's what our economy's been propped up on, is this false stimulus out there. So that you pull the steroid out, all of a sudden, you know, Mark McGuire, Tony, or the baseball players are hitting less than 70 home runs now all of a sudden. So what is the effect going to be on our economy? But more importantly, there's that macro economy out there, and then there's the economy between your own ears. Now, as a listener of this show, you know that we're the number one consumer advocate in Tampa Bay, and Michael Lysenko, he's a safe money coach. What we want to do is offer a free financial blueprint. This is going to teach you how to basically take control of your financial future. And for the first five listeners who text in, text the word financial blueprint to our consumer advocate hotline. What we're going to do is we're going to put you in touch with Michael. He's going to get you this financial blueprint. Take a look at your retirement portfolio, no matter what it might be. A lot of people pull money out of a pay stub, put it into a 401k, they call that a retirement plan. We call it a good start, but you're vulnerable. You've got fees that are hidden in there. You've got a looming bond bubble out there with what we were talking about with the Fed. A lot of concern. So, hey, it costs you nothing. It hurts. It's not going to hurt. It's only going to help you. So for the first five listeners who text financial blueprint to our consumer advocate hotline, we're going to give you this free financial blueprint. Also an opportunity to consult with Michael Lysenko, our safe money coach. So now pull out your smartphone, text financial blueprint to 813-917-1894 for the free financial blueprint. Text 813-917-1894. Thanks a lot, Michael. I appreciate you calling in. Those nuggets of advice, man.
Thanks, Brandon. Appreciate you. And I would just say just, you know, get money, get your retirement dollars out of the Wall Street casino and figure out how to get volatility out of what really matters, which is your money.
Right, yeah. I mean, there's some great programs. You got to have this one-on-one conversation with Michael and take control of your retirement. I mean, it could be you working an extra 10, 15 years. Like we had one of our own I won't use his name, but he was here in studio. He said it on air. His retirement, he watched it cut in half overnight, basically. And now he's working an extra 10, 20 years because of it. But, you know, take control of your financial blueprint and your financial legacy that you're leaving for your family. So, hey, thanks, Michael, Brandon. Thanks a lot. Appreciate you calling in, man.
You're welcome. Have a great weekend.
You too, bye. Bud. All right, that's Michael Lesenko, our Safe Money Coach. Now we're back here in studio. Jason Avery, Avery Construction, home remodeling, business construction, business remodeling as well. Scott Silverman, he's a small business attorney, business law attorney, Ackerman LLP, and Danielle Berg, our co-host and buyer rep, expert buyer agent representative. So let's go ahead and talk about that investor boat tour real quick, Danielle.
Yeah, we have an investor boat tour coming up. So if you're interested in joining us, text INVESTOR to our consumer advocate hotline at 813-917-1894. And you can join us to look at some of these properties from the water and see the view that you're really paying for.
That's right. Those million-dollar views that Jason was talking about earlier, that sometimes he goes in there and totally changes the floor plan of a home, removing some the load-bearing walls. You got to take those into account and all that good stuff. And one of the things that I consistently hear back is obviously an avid networker, Jason, and you're plugged into the business community like no other. And now that you have the author, you know, check that box off. You've got all these things that you're putting together. But I love the fact that your company has the computer-generated drawings, like I saw Danita do at one of our meetings where I have lunch. And you have that same-day pricing. It's so important. You know, there's a lot of contractors. You walk away, you're like, wait, what did I just do? I showed this person my house, and, you know, a week goes by, and you don't hear back.
Sometimes it's 2 and 3 weeks before you hear back. I hear those horror stories all the time.
Yeah.
Yeah, we have a policy, a same-day estimate guarantee, where we basically break things down into ranges, but in an itemized format. We'll discuss the permitting and the demolition, the drywall, the electric, plumbing, air conditioning, flooring, and the list goes on, yep. Right down to those parts and pieces that you're going to furnish as the homeowner, and what are the ranges of price on those products as well. So we try and paint a clear picture showing all the options, and then narrow in from there with each additional conversation that we have.
Yep.
You know, sometimes contractors just don't provide enough detail up front, and other times they try and hide behind a total number. And we're all about, you know, getting right down to it and providing the customer whatever it is they need at a budget they can afford.
Yeah, it's almost like they don't want to do the work. They don't want to dig in and see what the actual cost of materials are going to be, the cost of their labor, and they just want to throw that one lump sum number out there, and it's going to cause confusion for you, could potentially cause arguments between a husband, wife, and those types of scenarios.
That's where the word change order comes from.
Yeah, exactly. So we're going to dig in more about that with Jason when we come back. We're also going to talk to Scott Silverman with Ackerman LLP, business law attorney, and expert contributor here on the show. We're going to jump into some of those employment, some of the 1099 versus W-2 type setups with small businesses, and also Michael Jordan's bold plan to sell his $15 million home, slam dunk or foul. This is an article off of Realtor.com, and buy versus rent in Tampa Bay. Hey, great time to get off of that fence, get into home ownership, take advantage of the lowest rates that we've seen in 40 to 50 years, and they're not going to be here long. So you're listening to the Real Estate Quarterback Show. Check out our website, realestateradiotampa.com, and you can also check out all of our social media on Twitter, REQB Show, facebook.com/REQB Show as well. So you're listening to the Real Estate Quarterback Show, realestateradiotampa.com.
This is Warwick Dunn, and you're listening to the Real Estate Quarterback Show, hosted by my man, Brandon Rimes.
All right, welcome back. Thanks for sticking with us. Brandon Rimes here, host, Real Estate Quarterback Show, owner of Platinum MVP Realty, former USF football player. Got to give shouts out to the Bulls. Got a little momentum going now. Got that winning streak going. Played on the inaugural team under Coach Leavitt back in 96, 97. Seems like a long time ago now. But this segment's brought to you by the Maids Cleaning Service. They do a great job cleaning our real estate properties. The Maids, they come in, four fine folks. They're in and out. They let you know who was there. You get a full report of the property. You come in, property's smelling good, feeling good, looking good. And so also Harper's Carpet Cleaning. We got Harper's Carpet Cleaning. They do a great job for a deeper clean on your tile, grout, and carpets. It's shouts out to Joey Harper with Harper's Carpet Cleaning. They do an awesome job. They're voted number one by their peers as well, so that says a lot. Now, before we jump back into this great content, I want to touch on a couple of hot listings that we've got here. I've got 8303 Boxwood Drive. This is a four-bedroom, two-bath brick home in the 33615 area code of Tampa, kind of that Baycrest area, that Hillsboro Memorial Sheldon. Great buying opportunity here at $210,000. The property has been updated with new carpets and some other remodels. And we also have a fish farm here. This is a unique property. We've got a fish farm that actually Danielle and I co-listed on this one. We've got 10523 Tucker Jones Road in Riverview. This is 8.19 acres, a great opportunity for development or to relocate your business or just grow this business. It could be, you know, possible uses could be a gator farm, aquaponics, bees, catfish, sheep, cattle, goats, shrimp, all types of agricultural type uses there. And I also have a car dealership available on US 19, 7028 US 19, in Newport Richey. Great opportunity, just listed commercial opportunity on 19, high visibility with 300 feet of road frontage on that busy highway with lots of traffic rolling through there. So a couple different options there. So you're listening to a Real Estate Quarterback Show. It's Intelligent Talk Radio. We've got some intelligent folks here in studio. You've heard from Jason Avery, Avery Construction. Now we're going to focus in with Scott Silverman, Ackerman LLP, and also in the house is Danielle Berg, co-host and buyer agent representative. So Danielle, let's talk a little bit about the opportunity here. We got a couple of opportunities, seats open for our business expert contributor opportunities.
Yeah, we're looking for some expert contributors, especially a custom home builder. So if you know anyone that does custom builds that would be interested in joining our great team, or even a home stager, have them text expert contributor to our hotline, 813-917-1894. Or they can go to realestateradiotampa.com and fill the form out online and submit it to us.
That's right. Yeah, submit the form, realestateradiotampa.com. You also see links to all of our partners, expert contributors, and studio. And just a reminder, we've got the Wine, Women, and Shoes event coming up on November 20th. Really could use your support to help Children's Cancer Center. So Scott Silverman, Ackerman LLP, small business law, employment law, helping some of our consumers out there, these small business owners, avoid those common pitfalls that you see with employment law, and kind of like Jason was talking about with the 1099 versus the W-2 employee. Is that what you see a lot of out there?
Yeah, I really do. I see a lot of businesses that try to have individuals categorized as independent contractors,
yep,
and they're not really. They're employees. And the Department of Labor, which is the federal agency that governs this area of the law, they came out with an interpretation letter telling businesses that most of these individuals are in fact employees, not independent contractors.
Yeah.
So you can't avoid paying them the taxes, and you can't avoid trying to provide the employees what they're entitled to under federal law. Yep. And the problem is, if businesses do that, then they're going to owe the IRS money. They're going to owe back taxes, and they're going to owe for unemployment. They're going to owe for workers' comp, and they're also going to be subject to penalties. So it's a big issue. The federal government has looked at it and has told businesses that, you know, these people are really employees. You can't categorize them as contractors.
Yeah. Now, is that something where you would see punitive damages, something along those lines, or is it more compensatory?
You could. I mean, you could have somebody who is actually an independent contractor, and they could be entitled to punitive damages for some mistakes you may have made with them if they're actually an employee. But they're mostly compensatory damages. And then, again, the big issue is owing the government the taxes you didn't withhold and penalties on top of that. And it's a big issue for small businesses.
That's right. Uncle Sam wants their money, and if you try that, they're going to say,
come on, man. Come on, man.
They're going to say that. You know, and so it's one of those things as a small business owner, man, you got all this stuff going on, and I see challenges every week with my businesses and things I'm doing, and, you know, all of a sudden you get a left hook out of nowhere or right jab, and what can you do? You go to school, you learn your trade, you're an expert at what you do, and then you have these other areas that you may not be expert in. And that's the goal of this show, is we want to give you that helicopter view of things happening in Tampa Bay, things in the marketplace, and then also have these experts that we bring on each week to it's your most important hour on the radio and TV now each week, where, you know, we want you to, you know, be able to huddle up, call an audible, and at some point you want to rearrange what you're thinking about.
Omaha!
So let's call that audible with Peyton. Scott, what else are you seeing, man?
Some of the big issues for small businesses, in addition to the independent contractors, they think if I pay somebody a salary that they're automatically exempt from overtime law or minimum wage law, and that's not the case.
Right.
So that's a big mistake. Again, assuming somebody who's a salaried isn't entitled to overtime, that's not true, or not paying overtime correctly. A lot of small businesses don't realize that you can't give comp time, for instance, instead of overtime. So wage and hour issues are always a big issue for small businesses with regard to their employees. Another issue that we see a lot of is companies not having the appropriate documents, you know, handbooks, contracts, not having non-compete agreements if they need that for their employees, or confidentiality agreements.
Yep.
So those are things that, you know, companies need to have to make sure that they are protected.
Yeah.
And this is all about protection for the company.
Yeah, it's so important these days. You know, we're in this litigious society, and you see it happen with different people, and sometimes it even hits closer to home. You know, this is a litigious society. We've got the highest corporate tax rate on the planet. You know, I watched the debates this last week, and, you know, it's some of these issues that you see happening out there. But what I'm curious, too, how has the Obamacare or the Affordable Health Care Act, how has that affected your industry?
Well, for the small businesses, most of them are exempt from that. Only large businesses have to cover their employees.
Okay.
So it's really only had an effect on the larger corporations. The smaller businesses actually get a break under Obamacare. They can get a rebate from the government if they qualify for that. So that's something, a good tip for small business listeners of the show, is if they haven't already done that, if they do cover their employees, again, they don't have to, Brandon.
Yep.
But if they do, then they can apply and get a tax refund or a tax rebate for covering their small employees.
Okay.
And we've worked with some of our larger clients as well on that. And this may impact some of your individual listeners, obviously, are employed. Some of the larger corporations are not covering anymore.
Yeah.
Because of Obamacare, and have decided just to pay. It's cheaper to pay the penalty. So that's something we're taking a close look at as to whether, instead of covering more people, it may actually result in less people being covered.
Yeah. That's Scott Silverman, Akerman LLP, Small Business Law, Employment Law. Also in studio, Jason Avery, Avery Construction, and Danielle Berg, our expert buyer representative and co-host on the Real Estate Quarterback Show. I'm Brandon Rimes. I'm the owner of Platinum MVP Realty. And we got an expert panel here. We got a real estate roundtable discussion going on, talking about employment law, talking about home remodeling options. And before the break, we teased this story talking about buy versus rent in Tampa Bay. Buy versus rent in Tampa Bay. Home ownership costs less if you can qualify. Interesting story that came out from the TampaBay.com. It's talking about high cost of renting versus buying a home in metro areas has been well documented lately. Less known is how strikingly cheaper it is to buy rather than rent in Tampa Bay. A report issued by the real estate firm Trulia about millennials from 25 to 34 and their home housing options, buying a home in Tampa Bay is a whopping 42% cheaper than renting. So, kind of in that same area of a real estate discussion here is that, it's one thing we always talk to our listeners about. We want to help educate them. We want to engage them, most importantly, and inspire them to live a better life. And so one of the main things, you either fall into two camps, either you own a home or you don't. And so there's an opportunity now. One of the biggest things we want to talk to our listeners about these days is to get off of that fence, stop throwing away money, paying your landlord's mortgage when you could be building up your own equity, building a legacy for your family, taking advantage of the tax write-offs. And, you know, especially veterans out there, 100% financing. There's a lot of cool opportunities now. We've got some great lenders associated with this show. Shouts out to Achieva Credit Union, as well as Mark and Tony over at Integrity Financial Services. So whatever your reasoning for renting might be, we've got William Crowley, a.k.a. the Credit Magician, to help you with that. We really have a deep depth chart here to help you win in any marketplace and to be that turnkey solution. So we want to offer a rent versus own analysis for you. If you're out there and you're renting, what we want to do is have you text the word rent and the amount of rent that you're paying to our consumer advocate hotline. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to break down these numbers for you. We're going to show you a rent versus own analysis. It's going to break down, again, the amount of money you're throwing away versus what you could be building up in equity, building a better legacy, and taking advantage of that appreciation. You know, Tampa Bay is appreciating every year, year over year. A certain amount of folks from up north will be moving down. You know, you're paying down a mortgage and you're going to be building up equity, and that's money, basically money that you can access at some point if you need to. So text the word rent and the amount of rent you're paying to our consumer advocate hotline at 813-917-1894. Text rent and the amount you're paying to 813-917-1894. And we're going to do a rent versus own analysis. Also, before the break, we talked about Michael Jordan's bold plan to sell his $15 million home, slam dunk or foul. We're going to talk a little bit about that as well. And let's talk about our investor boat tour, Danielle. Let's get some investors ready to go out there.
Yeah, like I said before, if you want to go on an investor boat tour, just text us at 813-917-1894 or fill out a form online at realestateradiotampa.com. And you can join us and on the water and get some great views of the different properties you can own.
That's right. There's waterfront views that you pay so much money for. We want to help you enjoy those outdoors.
No shoes. No problem.
Also, shout out to Warwick Dunn Charities. He just did his 153rd home presentation, helping single parents with, in conjunction with Habitat for Humanity. Beautiful collaborative effort, and you know, friend of the program. Shouts out to Warwick Dunn Charities.
Warwick Dunn. Warwick spins to the 10. He's to the 5. 4-2.
And more from our experts in studio, a real estate roundtable discussion. We're going to get into our Tell Me Something Good stories and some consumer advocate tips and also questions from our listeners with our Ask the REQB. You're listening to the Real Estate Quarterback Show, realestateradiotampa.com.
This is Warwick Dunn, and you're listening to the Real Estate Quarterback Show hosted by my man, Brandon Rimes.
All right, welcome back. Thanks for sticking with us. We appreciate you tuning in each week. And you're listening to the Real Estate Quarterback Show, Real Estate Radio Tampa. com. This segment is brought to you by Smart Move Moving and Storage, the official moving partner of the Real Estate Quarterback Show. Say hello to Hannah. She's also a member of the Pinellas Realtor organization. They do a great job over there at Pro, as am I, and several of our expert contributor and partners of the Real Estate Quarterback Show. We have over 50 show partners now, ranging from CPAs, financial advisors, three or four different types of attorneys, all types of folks that are going to be a turnkey solution to help you win in any marketplace and to help you live a better life. I've got a couple of hot listings I want to touch on. I've got 12203 Four Oaks Road. Now, this is the corner of Gun Highway and Four Oaks. It's 1.6 acres, and there's about 40,000 cars that drive by daily. So this is a perfect opportunity for a small business owner, somebody that wants to buy a great piece of land here in beautiful Tampa Bay at $325,000. What a great offering price here for a 1.6 acre. Be ideal for a car lot, a discount auto parts store, one of those types of deals. And also Zero Merlin Drive in Newport Richey. Now, this is a cool property. This is just reduced down to $79,000, and it says build your dream home and an airplane hangar on this beautiful wooded lot. It's a vacant lot, a great opportunity in Hidden Lake Estates. Zero Merlin Live, Newport Richey. And also shouts out to Captain Will Smith out there. He's teaching me how to fly, getting my pilot license. And now that the winter is upon us, I'm going to go on the boat a little less and get up in those planes a little more while it's nice and cool outside in those small Cessnas. You know, there's no AC on those things. So they got you got to prop the window open a little bit while you're sitting on the runway. But let's jump back into this great content here. I've got Jason Avery, Avery Construction, Scott Silverman, Ackerman LLP, and Danielle Berg, our expert buyer representative and co-host here on the Real Estate Quarterback Show. Let's go ahead and jump into our questions from our listeners. Every week we have an opportunity for you to engage us by going online, Twitter, Facebook, and emailing questions to our different handles out there.
Yeah, you can hit us up on Twitter at REQBShow and Facebook.com/REQBShow. This question is for Jason. It's coming from Twitter, and it says, I am looking to remodel my kitchen. Is there anything I can do to prevent going over my budget?
Yeah, well, I would say, one, talk openly with the contractor about the budget. And I find lots of consumers that are hesitant to tell you what their budget is, as they're afraid that you might manipulate the information or take advantage. So that's one of the reasons why we actually do a same-day estimate guarantee, so that we can go ahead and put the ranges on paper for them right now, show them what the numbers could potentially be, and then say, now, where in this range would you like to fall? And that tends to open up the conversation so that we can, you know, plan with a target. Now, as you contract that project, it's very important not only to list everything that is included, but also to list anything that is not included. So there's really no room for error. There's no gray areas to be discussed later, because, again, that's where change orders come from. It's usually an oversight. It's usually something that was, you know, not discussed or not discussed clearly enough in the initial conversations.
That's right. Never make any assumptions. You know, same thing in real estate. We get those property disclosures. We're disclosing all known facts that materially affect the value of the property, so that way there's no gray area, like you said, Jason. And what's your next question there, Danielle?
What are some pitfalls you see with small businesses and their employees?
That's a great question, and we actually touched on some of them. I just wanted to get back to what Jason mentioned earlier, and I wanted to emphasize that, is this independent contractor issue.
Yeah.
Really important to when you're doing the construction, make sure the GC is treating their individuals properly and that they're properly covered. That was a great point. On this question, we actually covered some of it. The big mistake, if it deals with wage and hour issues, independent contractors. Some small employers should have at least 5 policies in place. I'm going to go through this real quickly. Anti-harassment policy, you know, wage and hour policy, social media, confidentiality, and at-will employment policies. Those are really important. So a mistake I see is employers not having those policies. Another thing employers really need to be aware of is having proper applications in place and proper background checks.
Yeah.
Because you don't know how much a bad employee can cost you, not just in bad work. But what we see in my business is that bad employees are the ones who sue.
Yeah.
So avoid that on the front end. And it's important to have these policies and procedures in place so employees know expectations and that you as a small business owner know what you're supposed to do.
That's right.
You know, how you're supposed to handle these issues. Finally, we have an old saying in my business, no good deed goes unpunished. So employers assume that as long as I'm fair to everybody and I'm a nice guy, nice business owner, I'm not going to have any problems, and that's not true.
Yeah.
So, you know, you have to be consistent, and you can't make exceptions for people and think that just by being fair you're going to avoid trouble.
Yeah, that's right. You talk about the retraining opportunities if you have a bad hire, and I like the one you said about social media. Kind of a uncharted place these days with the social media and you know, a lot of things that could be posted and the abuse that could happen. But great consumer tips. I want to remind you listening to the Real Estate Quarterback Show, Jason Avery, Avery Construction, Scott Silverman, Ackerman LLP. And if you want to engage us, it's realestateradiotampa.com. You got any questions or any comments that you might want us to link you up with these folks, please reach out. That's what we're here for. We're going to connect you with these great resources that we have as well. And let's go ahead and do our Tell Me Something Good segments.
Tell me something good.
So I was reading this morning, a Central Florida radio host, Kevin Sutton, is already camping out for Black Friday in front of Best Buy, which sounds really crazy, but it's actually for a great cause. Sutton stated that he wants to bring awareness to the more than 13,000 homeless children that are in Central Florida, and he's raising canned food, toiletries, and funds to help out the community.
Nice, like it.
Tell me something good.
All right, Texas officers buy 3 car seats for a man living out of his car instead of giving him a ticket. The man who didn't want to be named said it was nothing short of a miracle, and it was something that he really needed. The officers have been a blessing.
Tell me something good.
Thanks, Scott.
So for employees, tell me something good. Good is that no longer are most employees going to be exempt from overtime. Most employees who are now not getting overtime, the DOL has increased the salary level that you need to be exempt. So employees are going to be getting overtime. And we already talked about that most individuals are now going to be considered to be employees. So your individual listeners in the audience should see an increase in their pay and benefits as a result of these two developments. That's good for them.
Yep, absolutely. And Michael Jordan's bold plan to sell his $15 million home. So, of course, we all watched a lot of basketball, you know, in the 90s, and MJ was probably one of the best ever. There's always that debate. But he's selling his home, and it says that he's no quitter, even when it comes to selling his home. So he's got a Highland Park, Illinois property. It's been languishing on the market since 2012. He's back, and he says his new home strategy is a series of 6 Hollywood-style videos that appear sweeping aerial views of the 56,000-square-foot, 9-bedroom, 15-bathroom estate, along with the basketball court. And it says the price, it says $14,855, and those digits add up to 23, Jordan's famous jersey number, which is also on the Acres property entrance gate. So interesting story in the news there, Michael Jordan selling his property. And, you know, hey, another great show. And thanks so much for all you listeners out there, all the viewers as well. I want to remind you, we got a TV show out there on This TV Tampa Bay, Sunday evenings, 8 p.m., Bright House Channel 630, Verizon Channel 463. Check us out on our iTunes podcast. Just in case you missed these shows, we're labeling each one of our shows with the expert contributors that we've had on air. These are local resources that you can engage that can help you live a better life and provide you these timely truths centered around your real estate, credit, finance, estate planning, tax planning, so much more. Over 50 show partners now with the Real Estate Quarterback Show and growing. And we also want to invite any other sales associates out there, any other realtors that might want to make a change, take a look at joining an innovative company like ours. We're actually franchising, going nationwide. I've been offered a nationally televised TV show that's coming out in the spring. So we got a lot of momentum here, a lot of positivity happening with the Real Estate Quarterback Show. Thanks to our guest and expert contributors in studio, co-host as well. Thank you very much, Danielle. And we'll see you next week here, same time and place, realestateradiotampa.com.